Hello world, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to machine learning tutorial. So guys, we have seen so far how can we solve classification problem using logistic regression, KNN, support vector machine. But today, what I am going to discuss will be more interesting as I come up with decision tree algorithm. And this algorithm is one of the most popular machine learning algorithm used for both classification and regression tasks. As always, I will try to cover all the aspects of this algorithm, including problem solving by using both classification and regression approach. So guys, just a quick heads up for you. What we'll be going to discuss today is entropy, Gini impurity, information gain, and how can we select best splits by making use of these methodologies. So guys, if you haven't know anything about these terms, then you don't have to worry, as I'm going to explain all these in a very simple way. Just follow each and every steps and you will be able to understand all these concepts. So guys, I have divided this video in three parts, and today our focus will only be to understand basic intuition of entropy, Gini impurity and information gain. We will see how can we solve classification and regression problem using decision tree in upcoming sessions. Alright. So let's quickly start understanding what is decision tree and why we need this. So decision tree typically starts with a single node which branches into possible outcomes. Each of those outcomes leads to additional nodes which branches off into other possibilities. So in simple words, we try to create a tree-like structure where we can consider stem of the tree as root node, its branches as different conditional attributes, and fruit as final result. Let's understand this with one example. So suppose you want to go out for a vacation, but you are not sure where should you go. So what you will do is, you go to your friends and ask them to suggest you any place. And then you will categorize those places with some conditions. Let's say your friend A is suggesting you to go to Goa, and friend B is suggesting you to go to Uttarakhand. Now, you will have a look on all possible conditions to decide any of the places for your vacation. Now let's say your conditions are constrained to whether you want to go for a hilly area or beaches. Then whether you have budget of more than 15k bucks or not. Then your third condition will be like how many days you have to spend for this trip. Once you list out all these conditions, you will be able to prioritize where should you go for vacation. So basically, we are trying to create tree structure to reach to our final outcome, as you can see on the screen. Same we do in case of building decision tree algorithm, but with algorithmic approach that identifies ways to split a data set based on different conditions. So now I can say that the decision rules are generally in form of if-else statements. So let's understand how can we create these splits or branches and how can we say which branch is best. So guys, for answering this, we have some metrics, that is entropy, information gain and Gini impurity. Let's understand these one by one. Let's say we have some feature attributes, that is A, B, C, D as input and O as output, which is having either yes or no values. So based on different attributes, we have to predict whether output will be yes or no. So according to ID3 algorithm, our first step is to select the right attribute for splitting. So for considering which attribute should we use to split the tree, we use entropy function. See, if we don't select the right attribute, then our tree will go till the much depth and increase the time complexity as well. So guys, entropy measures the purity of split. Let's say my root node has 7 yes and 5 no. And when I split this into branches and come to node B, I got somewhere around 2 yes and 4 no. And at C node, I got 5 yes and 1 no. So guys, you can see that the split is not pure subtree, as it contains both yes or no. And pure subtree basically means that either we should be getting yes or no. So based on this, again I will split this subtree. So node D will be 2 yes, 0 no, and node E will be 0 yes, 4 no. Same we will do for node C. So here you can see that this can be categorized as pure subtree, as at this layer we have either yes or no component with us. So guys, for finding out the best split with pure subtree, we need entropy function. So guys, we have formula for entropy as sigma I equal to 1 up to C minus pi log base 2 of pi. Let's understand what is p over here. If I talk about node A, then p for yes can be considered as probability of yes over sum of probability of yes and probability of no. So now we have to compute the entropy for both the nodes for deciding whether we can go to node B or node C. So let's calculate the entropy for node B first. So here we have 2 yes and 4 no. Let's substitute these values to equation. Negative of 2 over 6. So here we consider our denominator as sum of probability of yes and probability of no, as I told you earlier. So negative of 2 over 6 into log base 2 of 2 over 6 minus 4 over 6. So here we have 4 no, and sum of probability of yes and probability of no is 6. So minus 4 over 6 into log base 2, 4 over 6. So after computing this, we can get entropy for this node as 0.92 bits. By same mean, we can compute entropy for node C as 0.65 bits. So guys, one thing to add here is that entropy ranges between 0 to 1. And we consider 0 as pure subtree, whereas 1 can be considered as worst scenario or most impure subtree when both yes and no are equal in number. So each time when we compute entropy, we consider the value which is more closer to 0. So guys, now we can say that node C is having less value, so we can continue with node C. But this is not it. Here we should also consider that after splitting this node, we may also require some other attribute to reach the leaf node. So we have to take entropy of those attributes too. And after adding up all attributes of a particular split till leaf node, then only we can justify that which split is best for our use case. So how can we achieve this? So guys, we have new matrix known as information gain. It combines all the entropy together till the leaf node. So formula for information gain is entropy of S minus sigma of V to values into S of V over S into entropy of SV. So here entropy of S we have just find out for each node, and S of V is a subset after splitting. S is total subset, and entropy of S of V will be, after splitting, we want to calculate the entropy for particular subset. I know this looks complicated to you guys, but we will understand this with one example. So again, I will consider the same split what we have used for understanding entropy. So here, node A is splitting into node B and node C, where node A has 7 yes, 5 no, node B has 2 yes, 4 no, and node C has 5 yes, 1 no. So according to the formula, first we have to calculate entropy of S, which is nothing but the entropy of node A, that is root node. So I will apply the same entropy function for this, and I can get it as 0.97. Then we will compute entropy of node B and node C, which we have already calculated as 0.92 and 0.65. So here entropy of node B and node C will be considered as entropy of S of V. Now let's substitute these values to the equation as shown on the screen. So guys, here we have to substitute S of V over S. Let's understand what is this. If I talk about node B, then S of V will be total number of components, that is 2 plus 4 is equal to 6, and S is total subset, that is 5 plus 7 is equal to 12. So we can substitute S of B over S for node B as 6 over 12. And for node C, S of V over S will be again 6 over 12. Let's calculate 0.97 minus 6 over 12 into 0.92 minus 6 over 12 into 0.65 and find out the information gain as 0.185. Now let's understand what it denotes. So suppose we have two splitting mechanism with us, one what we have just calculated and another one as shown on the screen. So we will find out the information gain for this as well. Then we will compare the two and we will only consider the splitting mechanism which is giving us the higher information gain between these two. So guys, this is very important to remember how to calculate information gain while considering entropy. As we have Python packages with us for automatically calculating the splits, but you should understand the inner functionality of these mechanisms. So guys, we have one more matrix and that is Gini impurity. Let's understand that as well, as we can either use entropy or Gini impurity. Both gives us the measure of purity but with different computational mechanism. So we already know the formula for entropy and we have seen how to calculate entropy for a particular node or attribute. So guys, formula for Gini impurity is 1 minus sigma of p square, where p is probability of yes plus probability of no. Let's understand this with one example. So guys, we have calculated the entropy for node C as 0.65. Let me substitute the values in Gini impurity equation for you. So that will be 1 minus p of yes, and here p of yes will be square of probability of yes over probability of yes plus probability of no, and this will be square of 5 over 6 plus probability of no, and probability of no will be square of probability of no over probability of yes plus probability of no, and this is calculated as 1 over 6. So Gini impurity will be 0.3. so we can clearly see that we are getting 0.5 as entropy for node C, whereas we are getting 0.3 as Gini impurity. Now I'm damn sure you must be confused that both are the same thing, then why we are getting different values, or which method we should use for computing purity of split. So let's understand this. So if you can see the screen, entropy ranges from 0 to 1, but for Gini impurity, range will be 0 to 0.5. And we use Gini impurity where we are restricted with computational power and shorter period of execution time, as we are not using any logarithmic function for calculating the Gini impurity. So here computational power will not be consumed that much. So best example for this should be ensemble technique like random forest. So guys, as now we have basic intuition about such matrix, we can design decision tree for both classification and regression problem. I will not stretch this topic more than this. We will see how we can solve classification problem by using these metrics in next session. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.